Welcome to Epi Info 7 training. In this video, you'll learn how to create drop-down lists using a codes field in the Form Designer. Drop-downs simplify and streamline the process of completing questionnaires. Also, drop-downs help minimize mistakes by eliminating the need to type responses. When using codes fields, at least two fields must exist. One holds the selection and the other receives the value. But note that both are stored in the database, and you can use both for analysis. For this example, we want to link the FIPS code to a county list. This means that every time a county name is selected from the list, the FIPS code will be automatically populated. This means that the county is my selection, and the FIPS code is the value. Remember that you must have two fields for the codes fields to work. I'm going to drag and drop a text field. This is going to be the county code. The field name will be the same, and since this is a list of codes, I'm going to make this read only and click OK. Now I need to have the codes field. This is going to be county name, and the field name will be the same. Notice that the county code field is already selected, so I'll be linking county name and county code. And I'll click the Browse button to do so. Since I don't have a table, I'll need to create one, so I'll click Create New, and I'll put in a few of the Georgia County names with their FIPS codes. So I'll click OK, and I'll click OK again. Now the Codes field and the Text field are linked. I can move them around on the form. And in order to test this, I need to be in the enterData function. We're in the enterData function. I'll click the drop-down. I'll click Atkinson, and County Code 2 populates. You have just been shown how to create a drop-down using a codes field in Epi Info 7. Thanks for watching, and look for more user support videos coming soon.